Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve example 1.4 that is taken from chapter number 1, Stress, and the book name is Mechanics of Material by RC Hibbeler, 9th edition. So statement is determine the resultant internal loading acting on the cross section at B of the pipe shown in figure, and A is subjected to vertical force of 50 Newton, a horizontal force of 30 Newton, and a couple moment of 70 Newton into meter. Neglect the pipe mass. So you can see this is the pipe that is acting upon by a vertical load of 50 Newton, horizontal load of 30 Newton, and there is a movement of 70 Newton into meter, and this pipe is fixed at point C. So you have to determine the internal loading at this point B. So for that, we will section this and we will draw the free body diagram. I have drawn the free body diagram here, you can see. So when you section it at this point, so you will be having two sections. One is this one and another one is this one. So we have taken this section, and the problem can be solved by considering segment AB. So we do not need to calculate the reaction at C. So let's start with the solution. So when you section it, so there will be forces at point B. Let we designate axis at B is, let this axis is known as x-axis. I will choose another color for different axis. The vertical axis is, let's say this is taken as z-axis, and the horizontal axis is taken as y-axis. Okay, so when you cut it, so definitely this will be the y-axis. Clear? So when you cut it, so you will see that you will having a normal force which is equal to fb y component, and there will be a movement that will be a counterclockwise along this y axis, and this will be movement about point B about this y axis. Okay, similarly for this z, when you cut this pipe at point B, you will be having a vertical force which will be equal to fb in the direction of z, and you will be having a movement that will be counterclockwise. This will be equal to mb about z axis. And same when you cut it, so you will be having a force along x axis. So this will be fb along x axis, and you will be having a movement counterclockwise. This movement will be equal to mb about x axis. So total three forces and three movements will be there. So we'll find this movement by using equation of equilibrium. The x, y, and z axis are established at B of the free body diagram of segment AB. The resultant force and movement component at this section are assumed to act in positive direction, and the and these forces are passed through the centroid of cross section at B. Now we'll find this by using equation of equilibrium. So first equation of equilibrium is that sum of all forces along x direction must be equal to zero. So what we will do is that you can see x direction is this direction. So only the force that is acting in x direction is this FBX, that is opposite to x direction, and there is no other force, because you can see this is not force, this is a moment given in the question. So only the force acting is minus FB x component, fb x component, and there is no other force there. So it means that this is equal to zero. It means fb x component is equal to zero. Now we'll apply another equation of equilibrium, that sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to zero. So this is y direction. So you can see along y direction one force is 30 Newton, and another force is this FBY, which is also along y direction. Their sum must be equal to zero. So I can write FBY component plus this 30 Newton is equal to zero. So from here, we will get this FBY component is equal to 30 Newton. I will make a box around it so that we can easily get what we have calculated. Okay, the third equation is that sum of all forces along z direction must be equal to zero. So this is z direction. About z direction, one force is this FBZ and another one is this 50 Newton. Both are acting opposite to each other. So I will write along the z direction, FB is z is positive because it is towards z, and this 50 Newton is opposite to it. So minus 50 is equal to zero. So from here, FB z component is equal to 50 Newton. We have calculated the three forces. Now we'll find the moment by using another equation, that sum of all moment about point B, sum of all moment at point B about x-axis will be equal to zero. So what is the x-axis? So you can see this is the x-axis. So one moment is this MBX, another moment about x-axis is 70, and the third one is this 50 Newton load into perpendicular distance 0.5, and it is also producing counterclockwise moment. So sum of all these moments will be equal to zero. So I will write MB about x plus 70 Newton into meter plus one thing is that this load is acting downward, clear, and this is the perpendicular distance, so it is producing clockwise movement, so it will be negative. So minus, this will be minus, so I have to change this plus with minus. So minus 50 into 0.5 meter is equal to zero. So when you solve this, you will get this movement of point B about x-axis comes out to be minus 45 Newton into meter. We will discuss at the end what does negative mean. Negative mean that your assumed direction is incorrect. It should be opposite toward to the what you have selected. Now we'll apply another equation of equilibrium, that sum of all movement about point B around y-axis is equal to zero. So let me show you, this is y-axis. You can see this is the y-axis. So moment about y-axis is this MBY, clear. And the second moment that is produced about this will be equal to, you can see that this is 50 Newton load, clear. And the perpendicular distance is this 1.25, clear. So it will produce counterclockwise movement about this y-axis. I will repeat this, 50 Newton and perpendicular is this, so it is producing counterclockwise movement about this y-axis. So I will write MBY plus 50 multiplied by 1.25. This, the sum of these two movements will be equal to zero. So when you solve this, you will get movement of point B about y-axis comes out to be minus 62.5 Newton into meter. Okay, and we have only left with the last equation, that is sum of all movement about point B around z-axis is equal to zero. So about z-axis, you will see that this is z-axis. So about z-axis, one movement is this counterclockwise, clear, and another moment that is produced about z-axis is 30 Newton into perpendicular distance is 1.25, and this is also producing counterclockwise movement about point z. So their sum must be equal to zero. So I will write MBZ plus 30 into 1.25 is equal to zero. So from here, we will get this moment MB about Z is equal to minus 37.5 Newton into meter. So all these are the internal loading. You can see we have calculated three loads, 1, 2, 3, and three moments at point B, clear, which is the answer of our this question. So at the end, we will see that note why the values are negative. So the negative values shows that your assumed direction, which you have taken here at moment about point B counterclockwise, about Z and about X, these are incorrect. it should be in clockwise direction in order to bring the equilibrium. Now what we will see that the normal force, I will write normal force at B will be equal to NB, and you can see that only normal force acting on point B is this FB. There is no other FBY component, so it will be 30 Newton. So I will write 30 Newton normal force at point B. This will be net normal force, whereas the shear force at B will be equal to VB, and you will see that there are two shear force acting on it. One is this FBX component and the another one will be FBZ component. So these two are perpendicular component. In order to find the net shear force, so net shear force by using Pythagoras theorem, it will be equal to X component is FBX is 0 while FBZ is 50. So 0 square plus 50 square will give you net shear force is equal to 50 Newton. Okay, and the last one is that we will see that this moment about y-axis, this producing torque at this surface. So this will be torque at point B. So MBY will be the torque. So torque or torsional moment is equal to MBY. And that is equal to 62.5 Newton into meter. This is equal to torsional moment at point B. And the bending moment MB, the other two moments are producing bending moment. So you can see that this moment MBZ and MBX, they are producing torsional bending moment in this segment AB. So we will write this in order to find the net. So this will be equal to 45 square plus 37.5 whole square. That will give you 58.6 Newton into meter. MB, this X component and Z components are the bending. So net moments acting, bending moment acting at point B is 58.6. So in this way, we are going to find out the internal loading at point B. And that was all about this example problem 1.4. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.